Here are the top 11 automation testing tools for 2021 that you need to know for the new year. But first, if you haven't already, make sure to like, share, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell down below, and get alerted every time I release a new video. So the first one, obviously, is Selenium. Now, Selenium for the past few years, to me, seems like it's fallen behind in innovation, mostly because they've been working on a major task of getting Selenium WebDriver, the W3 standards, in place and approved. But I think 2021, Selenium will be working on more innovative automation features in Selenium 5. In fact, Simon Stewart even kind of admitted to me in my latest interview with him when he said,
"So for a long time, we were busy doing the specification, and we sort of took our eye off the ball a little bit of how people were using it. And then once the spec was done and we had some space, we were then, okay, well, how will people want to consume this? Obviously, once I've left the project, I think there's going to be some interesting stuff coming in Selenium 5, because we've done these nice user-facing things, but they're all APIs. And the next thing that people want is things like, oh, can you download the browser for me? And can you download the Chrome driver for me, or the Gecko driver, or the MS Edge driver, or make sure the Safari driver on my system is configured properly? But I think sort of we've done some nice APIs in 4, and I think the sort of additional functionality would be a really interesting way for whoever is leading Selenium 5 to take the project. But
so look towards Selenium making more automation leaps in the future. So you definitely want to get on board if you haven't already using Selenium. The second one, if you're into JavaScript, is WebDriver.io. WebDriver.io is often called the next generation browser and mobile test automation framework, and mostly because it acts almost like a wrapper on top of Selenium. So if you're looking for an automation framework that leverages Selenium and allows you to program in JavaScript, or you want to run your test in different browsers using the Selenium grid, WebDriver.io is one of the most mentioned tools in my podcast that other automation experts recommend. Some reasons I think are it's a simpler syntax than you get using straight Selenium. It works with shadow DOMs, which is a lot of these newer applications use shadow DOMs. Kind of hard to use usually just using Selenium. WebDriver.io handles it. It also has useful debugging commands built into it, and it's a good choice for both QA and developers. Speaking of a developer's ecosystem, if you have more of a developer-centric testing culture at your company, Cypress is a tool that you should check out in 2021. So unlike Selenium, well, actually, the original Selenium didn't run in the browser, but Selenium WebDriver doesn't. So Cypress runs in the browser, so it allows you to interact with your code, the network, the methods, and even the DOM updates in real time. So any tool that's not running in the browser can't do this, but Cypress runs in the browser, so it leverages all this extra functionality because of that. So there's pros and cons to both, but one of the advantages of running in the browser is you're able to tap into all this other information. It also has built-in retries, and this feature is essential because modern web applications are continually updating themselves, but they're too unpredictable sometimes to automate or to time correctly. For example, during a test execution, my network might take a long time, so you can't just expect an element to appear in, say, let's say, like 100 milliseconds. That's why separate commands always have built-in retries and polling to ensure that even if element takes a little longer than normal, the test will pass, it won't be flaky, and it doesn't need hard-coded delays. So that's another advantage of using Cypress out of the box. And also, Cypress really concentrates on having a really easy install. With Cypress NPM, you could simply install a single command and get all the screenshots and videos by default on every continuous integration plugin on every platform. And so the ease of use really is one of the things that make up Cypress as well. And I've actually spoken to a lot of developers in my podcast, and one of the key things they say is it's fun to use. Cypress is fun to use because it doesn't interrupt their flow when they're developing, unlike Selenium in their experience. Selenium, they say, really is hard to pick up for them, but Cypress almost is like a seamless type of tooling into their world. So developer-centric organizations definitely should check out Cypress. Now, to me, Python is the best programming language due to its easy learning curve and flexibility. I use it like duct tape. It's awesome. So for Python folks that like Python, not necessarily these JavaScript options we talked about, or you don't want to have the overhead of programming everything yourself using Selenium, the Python bindings, there's something called SeleniumBase. I think it's one of the quickest ways to get started with automation in general is to install SeleniumBase. It's a feature-rich Python-based web application library. It uses both Selenium WebDriver APIs, PyTest, and includes cool features like reports, charts, and visual testing. And if you look at the TIBE index for December 2020, Python is the third on their list in growing languages, and it's gaining momentum. So if you're not on board with Python as well, I recommend just learning the minimal amount of Python because it'll help you in other things. When I was using straight up Java at another company, I still used Python behind the scenes to do a lot of administrative tasks that I was doing that was a manual task. But Python, because it was so easy, I was able to create these little scripts and include them in my CI/CD pipeline. So really is a big time saver. Definitely check it out. All right, so number five on my list, and this list is in no particular order, is Microsoft Playwright. And just this year, I spoke with many of the vendors, and they're really excited by it. They started creating solutions around it, like Testem has a free recorder tool that helps GUI functional tests that can be run as code on open source frameworks like Playwright. So really cool features. And the reason why I think Playwright was needed is today's web applications tend to be extremely rich and responsive. And additionally, developers are mainly building single-page applications that do a lot more in a browser tab than a web application used to do a decade ago. And these highly responsive behaviors of web applications is primarily powered by handling asynchronous events. So that makes it very hard to automate using existing tools. Hence, Microsoft Playwright. The team saw a need for a tool that could keep up and handle this newer approach. Playwright is a new open source cross-browser automation library for end-to-end testing. And the goal of Playwright is to provide a single API for developers and testers to automate their web applications across three major browser engines, Chromium, Firefox, and WebKit. I don't know if they're working on anything else. They seem to be improving on this day by day. And also, it originally started off as a JavaScript node library, but now it also supports multiple languages like Python, Java, and C Sharp. Really cool tool that you can use to do a lot of headless automation, a lot of things behind the scenes also. So definitely check it out if you haven't checked it out already. So next is Karate. Now, I first learned about Karate in early 2017 when the tool was still in the early stages of development and immediately saw potential in it. Since then, Karate has really matured into a stable tool with unique functionality that always adding to it. It started off mainly as API testing tool, but I know they've ventured into UI testing as well, so you can do both. You can do things like API testing doubles, front-end testing, API performance testing. All of this is available in one framework. So testing Karate I used using a BDD Gherkin-like syntax, but unlike most BDD frameworks like Cucumber, JBehave, and SpecFlow, after you write that BDD, you actually need to implement it in a step definition. So it takes some extra time. Karate eliminates that by including everything you need within the BDD statement itself or the Gherkin statement itself. So I'll be honest, some people love this tool and some people hate it. I don't know why. I don't know why I get so many mixed reactions with this tool. But if you're new to programming or automation testing, Karate is easy to use. It doesn't require any Java knowledge. And it has a really easy-to-use user interface. So if this is something that sounds great to you, you definitely should check out Karate in 2021. So another trend I've been seeing is more and more companies or more and more applications coming out using almost like a wrapper on top of Selenium. One of those that's becoming more popular is TestProject. So TestProject uses the best of breeds in Selenium and Appium behind the scenes in their framework. But it has added benefits of numerous other functionality that you don't have to create from scratch. The test project acts like a wrapper over other technologies as well, and it uses the power of what they have called add-ins. So they have a library of all these other add-ins that other people have developed that you can pull down using your project as well. So it saves you a lot of time in writing code from scratch. So if someone had an interesting REST kind of framework that they created, or an add-in for test project, they can add it to the library. You can download it and use it for your tests as well. So really cool community there. And so this means there's a lot of built-in functionality available to you within the test project ecosystem that remedies a lot of things that you need to do normally having to code from scratch when creating a new automation framework. So they seem to always be working on adding features. And recently they came out with some new AI-based features that I haven't seen from any other or not many other free tools. So this is a free tool, but they have baked in AI functionality now that they're adding on as well that usually only get when you pay a vendor for. So definitely something you should check out if you want to get a little more involved into AI or kind of this codeless type automation. You could do both code and codeless based automation this as well. So it's a great tool to pick up, download, and get you familiar with for maybe people on your team that aren't automation experts, or maybe you are an automation expert and you just want to focus in on other things, not necessarily writing everything from scratch. This might be a good project or a good option for you in 2021. Right, so far, I've only covered functional automation tools, but if you've been following me for any amount of time, you know that I'm a big believer in automating anything in the CI/CD pipeline that can help you deliver quality software faster. So it doesn't necessarily need to be a functional test. It could be security test, a performance test. It could be infrastructure, building infrastructure with scripts. Anything like that is what I consider automation testing tools or automation tools. One of these tools, a number 8, is Chaos Monkey. So you may have heard of chaos engineering. It's been described as being like preventative medicine in that it's a disciplined approach to identifying failures before they become outages. And so the best approach to achieving chaos is to actually proactively kind of inject or test your system, how it responds under stress. And you can then identify and fix features or failures before they impact your customer or cause damage to your reputation due to the poor publicity of an outage you could receive because you didn't test all these edge cases that could occur within your application. And that's where Chaos Monkey can help. So Chaos Monkey is a tool you can use to randomly terminate instances in production to ensure that engineers implement their services to be resilient to instance failures. You can do a whole bunch of things with it to interject these type of chaos instances. So you can test these weird edge cases before, like I said, your end users get to. So if you haven't checked out Chaos Monkey or Chaos Engineering, definitely check it out. I think it's a technique your team could really benefit from if you haven't done any of this type of testing before. So another trend you've been probably seeing, as I have over the years, is the shift left movement of trying to test things earlier and earlier in the software development lifecycle. And because of that, we've seen a lot of these automation tools we've talked about earlier really plugging in earlier and earlier in our test lifecycle and our CI/CD pipelines. But one of the lagging tools or areas that have been behind is performance testing and security testing. And because as we shift things earlier and earlier in the software development lifecycle, that means developers need to get more involved with all these other testing type of activities. One of the activities that I see that a lot of teams fail with is performance and stress testing. So a lot of these responsibilities are falling in on developers as well. How can you lower the performance barrier to help get your developers involved in load and stress testing? K6 is a developer-centric load and performance testing tool. You can use it to describe performance-based user journeys or scenarios and have K6 run them for you. And one of the main issues that you can deter a team from adopting performance testing practices is that not many companies design their performance tools with developers in mind. So they don't necessarily use the same languages as the developers. K6 was designed to integrate seamlessly into your developer's CI/CD pipelines, so they can use it from the command line, they can use their programming languages, the same IDEs they're using for coding their front end or their functional test. You can also use for performance testing now using K6. So you're treating now performance tests like code as well. So the same practices used for any type of other type of coding for your automation tests, for your unit tests, will also now apply to performance testing using K6. It's a really unique approach. So rather than waiting to last minute to have some performance team take care of performance, you can start to get your developers involved. And K6 is a gateway tool to help you achieve that. Definitely check out K6 if you think you have developers that will benefit from it. Or if you're a test automation engineer that wants to get involved in performance testing, K6 is also a great option for you. So also, the next two tools, as we go into 2021, I keep thinking about monitoring. So test monitoring, I think, is going to be a big thing in 2021. So a few companies I've spoken with over the past year on my podcast, one of them is Checkley. So more teams are picking up DevOps in 2021. So more agile teams are going to have to be responsible for the reliability of their application. So as you saw in Chaos Engineering, Chaos Monkey, all that has to do with the resilience of an application. Because now teams are more responsible, not just for testing, but also making sure the application is responsive, it's resilient once it hits production. So it's not once it's in production, you forget about it. It's in production, you have to fix it. And then based on that, you put it into your whole feedback loop. And then when you're developing software from the beginning, you take what you learned from the production and you build it in from the beginning, and it's a continuous type of cycle. So I say all that because monitoring is a critical piece I see a lot of teams missing. And a tool like Checkley can help you with that. So Checkley is an API and end-to-end monitoring platform for modern type applications written in JavaScript, and they're flexible and programmable. Anything your developers are really hot on. Also, because there's a need for tools that fit into both developers' workflow and for helping testers that are working together with developers, you really want to have a tool that everyone understands and the team can use, and build out a true end-to-end automation test suite. So it's not just getting you to help you build out a true end-to-end test suite, and that now includes production as well. So Checkley is an API and end-to-end monitoring platform solution for modern web applications. Definitely check out Checkley for that. And number 11, we have DeepFactor. And just so you know, Checkley and DeepFactor, they have both paid options and they have a free option. And even if you don't have the pay option, you could still benefit from both these tools. DeepFactor is a continuous pre-production monitoring platform that's designed for developers, and it provides security, testing, performance, and behavior visibility seamlessly integrated into your CI/CD pipelines so that engineering teams can not just release their software at the speed of DevOps, but they can also release it fast with confidence. And as I'm saying, in 2021 and beyond, not only are we trying to develop or deliver quality faster and faster, you want to be able to do it fast with confidence. And using tools like DeepFactor, Checkley, K6, all these other tools are going to help you achieve that. So let me know what you think. Let me know if I missed anything. And if you like this, why not subscribe, hit the bell down below. And also, if you really want to go deep in on automation and accelerate your efforts in 2021 and beyond, I highly recommend you check out Automation Guild. It's an online conference I started 5 years ago before all this COVID-19 happened, dedicated to testers to help them with all their automation efforts. So our goal at every Automation Guild is that you learn a tip, tool, technique, best practice, a mindset that's going to help you and your teams accelerate your automation efforts in the new year. You definitely want to check it out. Head on over to automationguild.com and register today. As always, test everything and keep the good. Cheers.